functional programs on multi-core processors, and Katsuhiro Wino will give a talk. I hope I didn't butcher that too badly.
Thank you for the introduction. So I'm Katsuhiro Wino from SM Sharp Project. So by the way, I'm very excited at this precious opportunity to play some role on such an excellent NO stage. So unfortunately, this is not NO, but research talk is something similar to NO, because both force guests to picture what is going on the stage. Yes. So anyway, so this talk is about garbage collection, detail of garbage collection. So NO Lambda appears in this talk at all. So So nowadays, as you know, multi-core processors have become a commodity, and the world has entered the multi-core era. Yes, in this era, the performance is in proportional to the number of cores. So if you have 64 cores, your program is expected to run 64 times faster. Yes. So yes. It is difficult, actually. Yes, I know. But this is expected. Yes. So the source of this speed up is multi-thread on multiple CPUs. Yes. Operating system provides state-of-the-art native thread support. So exploiting it is key technique to survive in this era. So for any high-level parallel computation construct, so to make some contribute to the performance, it must be implemented on top of the native threads. Yes, so this is a reality. And this is what C programmers are doing now. But how about ML? Unfortunately, ML is not to go along this line for some reasons. So a major reason is stop the world garbage collection. So yes, I know that parallel copying collector is quite fast, but yes, it requires mutated tuples. If you have 64 native threads in your ML program, you at some timing, you cannot control. You have to wait for 64 threads to be stopped. Yes, apparently this is not good situation. Yeah. A possible solution is concurrent garbage collection, which never stops any mutators, never interfere with allocation, and certainly works even if tons of native threads exist. And of course, it's designed for ML, not for Java, which is a favorite language of garbage collector researchers. Yes, this is what we develop, and this is what we propose today. So the key idea of our concurrent garbage collection is that these two techniques can scale up to massively many threads by their construction. One is our previous work on non-moving collector for functional languages. It includes almost everything suitable for concurrent collection. In particular, each of mutator can have its own allocation devices to allocate an object directly into the global heap. Another is USART snapshot abstraction, which only looks at the snapshot for collection, and therefore does not need to trace mutated state during collection, in contrast to Dijkstra's tricolor marking. Yes. We combine two into an algorithm, and this is what we present today. So the technical point is how to take snapshot without stopping multiple mutators. Yes, so first of all, let me introduce our previous work. The entire heap is organized as a set of segments. Each segment consists of allocation blocks and a bitmap indicating free blocks and an allocation pointer. To allocate an object, mutator obtains the segment and advances the allocation pointer to the next free block, like this. And as segment get filled, it is moved to the field list for future reclamation. So note that all the as you see in this animation, all devices for allocation are packaged in a segment. So this algorithm can be extended easily to the multi-thread. So the set of segment is globally shared and is implemented as a lock-free stack. Each of mutator obtains its own segment with its own allocation devices, and block allocation is done individually at the same time, like this. So block allocation never increases memory contention. Yes, and the number of mutators is bound to the number of segments, which is possibly infinite. In addition, there's no interference between mutators and correctors because correctors only look at field list. Okay? So, so as you're seeing so far, everything for concurrent correction is almost everything is in it. Yes. The only remaining piece is how to correct concurrently. So we adopt US snapshot abstraction for concurrent correction. So this abstraction says that at the beginning of a correction cycle, somehow save the entire heap and entire root set as a snapshot. Then a set of objects to be grammed can be determined only from the snapshot, regardless of the mutator state. This is all about the USR snapshot abstraction. Very simple. So the snapshot garbage collection algorithm immediately follows this abstraction. At the time T0, a correction cycle starts. So immediately starts the corrector thread so that the tracing can be done concurrently. And then somehow save heap H and root set R. After that, corrector thread traces objects only according to snapshot H and R. So no matter how mutator works, or no matter how many threads exist. Yes. So this is very simple and obviously correct. And so this is what we adopt for our garbage collection. Yes. So the remaining piece is how to save H and R. Okay. So so for H, H may be changed by either memory update or allocation, object allocation. From memory update, we can save H by remembering all the pointer of all update before after T0. This can be done by turning on the snapshot write barrier at T0. And for object allocation, we can save H by saving allocation pointers of all segments at T0. Because H0 consists of all objects before the allocation pointers. Okay, so how about root set? So this is slightly complicated because we don't stop mutators at all. So, corrector at time T0, corrector requests the root set, but each of mutator responds to the request at some time later than T0. There's a time lag, and so therefore we cannot obtain the exact one. So to somehow we need to fill this gap. So to fill this gap, we follow the idea of sliding view proposed by Lebanoni and Petrank. This is a summary of our reformulation of the idea of sliding view. So if we remember the new pointers of all memory update between T1 and T2, then we can safely reclaim this kind of set of objects. So I omit the detail, but this summary says that what we really need is H of T1. Okay, so let's revisit how to save H of T1. So we want to save H of T1. So this means we need to make sure to turn right barriers before T1 and save the location point at T1. But due to the time lag, we cannot exact H of T1. We cannot obtain exact H of T1. So H of T1 is like this, but what we saved is like this, a little larger than exact one. So instead, instead of exact one, we choose a conservative one for each purpose of H of T1. Okay, we found all of what we need. So to determine all of them, mutators and correctors must need to make some collaboration with each other. So for this purpose, we organize a kind of handshaking protocol, similarly to Doige and Gontier's work. So initially, all mutators and correctors are in async phase. And at the beginning of the correction cycle, the phase is changed into sync one. At this phase, mutators turn on their write barriers and send acknowledgement to corrector. After that, during this phase, the remembered pointers are pushed into the threshing stack. After that, collector determines the correct set and enters sync to phase. In this phase, mutators save allocation point and enumerate root sets. So root objects are pushed into tracing stack. After that, it turns into the mark phase, and collector begins tracing. Mutator turns off the snooping write value, and during this phase, both mutator and the collector access it to the tracing stack. So when the tracing stack becomes empty, all of them return to the async phase. That's it. So I think that you have noticed that there is memory contention in this algorithm. So in this algorithm, there are only two sources of memory contention. One is in the set of segments. But this is not serious because it is Lockheed stack. Another is serious. The source of contention is in the tracing stack. This is serious, so we need to design and implement it very carefully. In our implementation, to avoid memory contention as much as possible, we split the tracing stack into four distinct object lists. Including the detail of this design, we have done a lot of engineering so that this collector works efficiently. But in this talk, we omit these details, but this is a paper for details. Okay, so let me show our current performance evaluation. We have implemented in our SMSharp compiler version 3. And we use a NUMA machine equipped with 2 8-core CPUs. So we have 16 cores in total. So we have three benchmark results. The first one is overhead of machineries we introduce for concurrent correction. So red one is concurrent, and blue one is a trivial stop of the world variant. The taller one is slower one. And from this graph, we conclude that the overhead is about 12 on average, 12% on average. So this overhead is reasonable compared to any other related work, one of which reports 30% to 80% slowdown. Yes. Second one is speed up of parallel benchmarks against the number of threads. So as seen in this graph, concurrent version is comparable to or slightly better than stop the world version. But unfortunately, in any case, speed up is up to 8 times, whereas we have 16 cores for some reason. We don't identify the reason, but probably due to NUMA architecture. So we need to tune up everything before taking further analysis. And the last one is muted at pause time. So this result is what we expected. In almost cases, concurrent pause time is almost zero. Okay. So let me conclude. So how many times I spent? So let me conclude my talk. So we develop a concurrent corrector, which never stops any mutators. And so it must be scaled up to massively many threads for functional programs. We develop this corrector by combining two techniques that scale up to massively many threads by deconstruction. So to perform correction without stopping mutators, we followed the two existing ideas. So there's a lot of future work, but today I'd like to introduce the most interesting one. So we believe that we have established the infrastructure of massively parallel computation in ML by this concurrent garbage collection. Combining it with SMSharp's seamless interoperability, we can import the state-of-the-art massively parallel C library designed by professional researchers and engineers in that field. So we are currently working on this. And our current target is massive threads, C libraries, presented by Nakashima and Taura, which provides lightweight user level threads. So stay tuned. That is all. So thank you for listening.
So we have lots of time for questions. So,
Mihao Gaidan, Hackerspaces G. So since there is a lot of time, I would like to ask two questions. One, how many memory channels do you have on your NUMA system?
How many what?
Memory channels do you have there?
Memory changes?
Yeah.
I have no data for that. Yeah.
The second question is, when you have the separate allocation machinery, is it also calling the operating system separately on the same processor, on the same core, on which you are using the data later on, or memory later on?
So I can't understand your question.
So I think currently Linux allocates the memory differently, the virtual memory differently, depending of which core calls the function.
Yeah.
Do you use this capability, or do you?
No. Yes. So this is the reason why our program does not scale. So our program is not NUMA aware.
Thank you very much.
Ryan, I guess it's.
Ryan Newton, Indiana. I wanted to ask a little bit about what falls into the category of seamless interoperability with C. So a non-moving collector seems wonderful for interoperability. And I'm wondering if, one thing that's been slow in our community is the porting and implementation of a full collection of block-free data structures into parallel functional languages. In your system, you have the opportunity of using pinning is very, very cheap in your system, I imagine, and you have the opportunity of pointing to SML data structures from external C data structures to reuse existing lock-free data structures. Is that something that you're doing or thinking of?
Sorry?
Yeah. Can C data structures point to SML objects in your system?
Your question is? Pointer from C to ML.
Yes.
We don't trace that.
Okay.
Yes.
Thank you. I'd love to talk about it offline.
Hello, Damien Doliger from INRIA. I would like to know whether your garbage collector. The collector itself is parallel, or is it only one thread doing the collection?
Our collector is not parallel, but we want to extend our collector to the parallel collector.
Because if you want to scale to a large number of processors, you will have to make it parallel.
Yes. Thank you.
There's a question over there.
All right. Well, Masahiro Yatsugi, Kyushu Institute of Technology. I belonged to your SAS laboratory before, and thank you for using the SAS algorithm. And I think US also proposed to use return values to trace root to protect from the concurrent upgrade. So. Mutator itself changes its stack state, so to protect it from the changing, it uses some kind of barrier. Do you use that kind of barrier, or do you use some another technique? As you mentioned,
right barriers we use is right barriers we use are. Snapshot and snooping. Snapshot barrier is your search one.
So in your search algorithm, it must save all root of all root at the beginning. So that part cannot be concurrently performed. Saving root cannot be.
Right over the for root set, you mean?
So do you use some kind of protecting root from
changing? No, at all, because it will incur very large overhead.
Yes. So process users also propose to use some kind of barrier to change breaking some root.
Thank you. We will consider all it.
So you don't use that?
Yes. We don't protect the root set at all by write barriers.
Edward Yang from Stanford University. Thanks for an interesting talk and cool numbers. So this is ostensibly a garbage collector for ML. So I was wondering, is there anything in particular about ML that, you know, makes your strategy work better? As opposed to, you know, if you were trying to do a garbage collector for another language.
So sorry.
So what about your garbage collector is specific for ML?
Not specific for ML, but we are using ML. So we say this collector is for ML. But yes, this collector can be used for any other functional languages like Pascal. There's no reason to hesitate to use it.
Okay, thanks.
Okay, I guess we can thank the speaker again and have coffee. You.